Hello, this is Quick News with Doug. So we'll start out with the United States cases. We are currently at 392,000 with 12,370 deaths. So I think this is the biggest jump we've seen. Can't remember what it was yesterday. I think it was, what's the date? One second. Okay, so the cases yesterday, I do not think were past coronavirus cases yesterday. I don't think they were past 10,000. I guess they, I mean, the deaths were past 10,000. So, doesn't say, but if I remember correctly, it was at around 9,000, 8,000 deaths, and now it's at 12,370. So, this has been a big jump. It's gone 3,000 deaths increased. So, France also became the fourth country to pass 10,000 deaths at 10,328. This is actually interesting. We have the most cases by quite a bit. The second is 140,000. We're at 392,000. Italy has 135,000. So they're a little less than a third than what we have in cases. They're 200,000 behind us. Yet they have 5,000 more deaths than us. So for the amount of cases we have and still being less than Spain and Italy, Italy is 5,000 more and they only have a third of what we have, a little less than that actually. I guess that's good because it just proved that I guess we handled the deaths better, not the cases, but the deaths better than Italy. So, yeah, France became the fourth country to pass 10,000 deaths. Trump warns of a lot of deaths this week. A lot of people are saying this could be the peak. Trump's saying it's a bad week. It's going to be, if this is the peak, then it will stop this week and then start, it won't be increasing really at all, which would be good. It'll start going down. By the end of the summer, this will probably, hopefully this will just be gone. And then in the next 4 years, we'll have another Chinese pandemic. Or this will just become a seasonal flu, which wouldn't be as good because even the seasonal flu causes around 60,000 deaths every year. So, let's see. Right now, the world confirmed deaths are 81,000 with COVID-19. In the U.S., I don't know if it's the U.S., but it's either the U.S. or the world. The flu, I'll just look it up. The flu causes that many deaths. So it would be better if the coronavirus just went away, didn't become seasonal. But as long as it's not continuing up, that would be better. Deaths does flu cause. How many people die from the flu each year? Let's see, according to the CDC, between 29,000 and 59,000 people have died from the flu. See if that's the U.S. In the U.S. Around 30,000 to 60,000 people in the U.S. die from it. So doctors around the world are also saying that, I don't know how to say, I think it's hydroxychloroquine. I think that's how you say it. and antibiotics successfully treated coronavirus patients. A lot of people are saying that this has worked before. It's working now. Doctors are saying it now. It's different than fish tank cleaner. It's a lot different. So this isn't gonna kill you if you have it. I mean, it may help. So my last thing for today is pretty sad. China, they've been lying. They've not been letting people in the hospitals to keep it down, the cases down. They've been doing a ton of bad stuff. This is all their fault, and they're trying to make it seem less. They're letting everyone go, even though reports of the cases are still around. It's not gone down really that much. So I guess locals in Wuhan, China, have heard screams coming from funeral home furnaces, and some treated in hospitals say that they saw workers put living, alive COVID-19 patients in body bags, according to Radio Free Asia. So apparently, people are saying, people in the hospitals have said it, and people have heard screams. Guess they're burning people alive in body bags, which is terrible. But I don't know what they're thinking. They just want to keep the cases down. This is absolutely the worst thing to do. It's like burying somebody alive. So there's re been reports of them now, after not letting them in the hospital, burning alive COVID-19 case, burning alive COVID-19 victims. So that's absolutely terrible. It's probably gonna give me a nightmare, to be honest. So that's it for today. I will see you on the next episode, and thank you for watching.